صلى الله على آله وصحبه وسلم. We start in the name of God, the most beneficent, the most merciful. All praise is due to God, the Lord of the worlds. And may peace and blessings of God be upon His Prophet Muhammad, His family, and companions. Students, faculty, friends, and colleges, I greet you all with the Islamic greeting of peace. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today is the first event in a series of events called Israel, the Politics of Genocide. In the coming weeks, we will be expounding on Israel's suffocating policy to the Palestinian people. We are honored to be hosting a number of prestigious guests, from ACLU lawyers to Green Party candidates to British parliamentary members. Before we begin today's event, we will begin with some verses from the Holy Book, the Quran.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ولله ما في السماوات وما ولقد وصينا الذين أوتوا الكتاب من قبلكم وإياكم أن اتقوا الله وإن تكفروا فإن
بالقسط شهداء
منه فلا تتبعن الهوى أن تعدلوا أو الوالدين يا أيها الذين آمنوا كونوا قوامين بالقسط شهداء أو الوالدين والأقربين إن يكن غنيا أو فقيرا فالله أولى بهما فلا تتبعوا الهوى أن تعدلوا وإن تعدلوا أو تلووا فإن الله كان بما تعملون خبيرا صدق الله العظيم.
And to Allah belongs whatever is in the heavens and whatever is on the earth. And we have instructed those who are given the scripture before you and yourselves to fear Allah. But if you disbelieve, then to Allah belongs whatever is in the heavens and whatever is on the earth. And ever is Allah free of need and praise. If He wills, He can do away with you, O people, and bring others in your place. And Allah is ever competent to do that. Whoever desires the reward of this world, then with Allah is the reward of this world and the hereafter. And ever is Allah hearing and seeing. O you who have believed, be persistently standing firm in justice, witnesses for Allah, even if it be against yourselves or parents and relatives. Whether one is rich or poor, Allah is more worthy of both. So follow not personal inclination, lest you not be just. And if you distort your testimony or refuse to give it, then indeed Allah is ever with what you do acquainted. After the recent bloody Israeli offensive in Gaza, Reem Salahi traveled to the region as part of a National Lawyers Guild delegation. Their job was to assess the effects of the attacks and determine what violations of international humanitarian law occurred and whether U.S. domestic law had been violated as a consequence. Having returned, Salahi has been traveling through the U.S. presenting what they have found. She will share the stories of the people of Gaza through photographs and video footage. Salahi spoke to families and workers impacted, as well as medical personnel, heads of NGOs, and United Nations representatives.
Hello, and assalamu alaikum. Thank you guys for having me come. Unfortunately, it's very sad circumstances that I'm here today to speak about the recent onslaught in Gaza. I was part of the National Lawyers Guild, and it was a small delegation of lawyers that went, 7 lawyers and 1 law student, and we had a documentarian who also came with us. And the idea of the delegation was to go to Gaza after the recent attacks on Gaza to really assess what happened on the ground and really to try to get testimonies of the experiences of the people there. So we went and we spent a week there from February 2nd to February 8th, 2009. We crossed over through Rafah. And at that time, from what I understand and what I know to date, we are the only U.S. legal delegation to have gone to Gaza. There was a British delegation, a legal delegation that tried to get in, but they were turned back. So I'm not sure how much, even internationally, how many lawyers have been able to go. So what I'm presenting here are basically my pictures, some of the videos that our documentarian took when he was there, as well as the accounts that we heard, some of the accounts that we heard. And I divided it up in a way where I basically look at the various allegations that we constantly heard about, we read about, we were told, and particularly in the U.S. media. You know, if you go to Europe or if you go to other countries, their media is a lot less sensitive.